Wirehaired Pointing Griffon. The Wirehaired Pointing Griffon is a medium-sized dog bred to serve as a close-hunting gun dog. While griffon-like dogs are believed to have been around since as early as 500 BC, the exact development history of the wirehaired breed is well documented and begins in 1874. Eduard KarelKorthals, a Dutch breeder and hunting enthusiast, began assembling the perfect gun dog in his kennel in Germany by bringing together 20 dogs representing 7 breeds. Breeding selectively for qualities like agility, endurance, trainability, body structure, and pointing and retrieving ability, he succeeded in fixing the new breed by 1886. His connections in France helped the breed become particularly popular in the country, eventually reaching England and the US. The breed's reputation as a versatile hunter with a good nose grew in the subsequent decades till the Second World War. While faster dogs have become popular over the years because of competitive field trials, the Wirehaired has maintained a loyal following among dog lovers who fancy its hunting abilities as well as its companionable nature. Time for some rough trivia. When the Wirehaired Pointing Griffon first appeared in the US in 1887, it was registered as the blank setter. Which country was it mistakenly considered to be from? A. Russia. B. England. Or C. Belgium. What do you think? Give it your best guess in the comments below before we get to the answer. Hang on tight and we'll get back to this rough trivia question toward the end of the video. The adult male Wirehaired has a height in the range of 22 to 24 inches, while the female is slightly shorter. The weight range for the adult dog is 50 to 60 pounds. Its strong limbs lend it a cat-like grace and help it cover any kind of terrain easily. The square-shaped head is covered with abundant eyebrows and mustache, with large, somewhat rounded eyes and medium-sized ears that lie flat and close to the head. The distinctive double-layered coat consists of a medium-length, straight and wiry outer coat and a fine undercoat. The harsh texture of the top coat provides the dog insulation, water resistance, and ability to move through thick undergrowth. Acceptable colors are steel gray, chestnut brown, white and brown, roan, and white and orange. Grooming. The Wirehaired's wiry coat needs regular brushing and hand stripping for maintenance and removal of dead hair. The occasional bath is useful. Apart from the usual cleaning of ears to remove wax buildup, this breed also requires plucking of hair within the ears to prevent ear-related problems. Brushing of teeth and trimming of nails have to be regular too. Temperament. The Wirehaired was bred to be a friendly animal, which is reflected in the sweet temperament of most dogs of the breed. It gets along well with everyone, humans, other dogs, pets, and particularly children. It loves to spend time with its human family and should not be made to live alone. Called the supreme gun dog, the Wirehaired retains all qualities that would be expected from a versatile, devoted, fearless dog that hunts in close company with its human master. Training. Again, having been bred for trainability, the Wirehaired can be taught easily not just to be an excellent hunter, but also to perform many other functions. It is a very active breed, built to spend time outdoors and requires substantial exercise for at least an hour every day to stay happy. This can be in the form of swimming, hiking, playing in a fenced area, or a long walk. Health. The typical lifespan of the Wirehaired is 12 to 14 years. This is a very healthy breed, with some occasional concerns that could arise being hip and elbow dysplasia, entropion, ectropion, congenital heart disorder, and otitis externa, inflammation of the auditory canal. Good-looking, hard-working, devoted, and fun-loving, the Wirehaired Pointing Griffon is a dog carefully put together over several years. Just keep in mind that this is a sporting dog that is best suited for an active owner who can give it plenty of exercise. Find out if the Wirehaired Pointing Griffon would be a good addition to your home. Now you can visit brooklinscorner.com to take our quiz and find out which dog would be the best match for you. Let's get back to the answer to our rough trivia question. When the Wirehaired Pointing Griffon first appeared in the US, it was registered as the Russian Setter, because any furry dog was assumed to be of Siberian origin in those days. That does it for the Wirehaired Pointing Griffon. If you enjoyed this Dog Facts 101 video, be sure to subscribe and paw that thumbs up button. Then go ahead and check out some of our other videos or fun activities on our website. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.